Hello, my name is Danny Nolan and I'm the Director of ChassisSim Technologies. And welcome to this latest ChassisSim video tutorial. Today, the subject of our tutorial is ChassisSim 101, how do you get going? And in particular, this tutorial is geared for those first-time users who have never used ChassisSim before or might have just played around with on the edges of ChassisSim and are just sort of struggling. What do I need to do to get going? What do I need to roll out? Well, if that's you, this tutorial has been specifically tailor-made for you. And as you're about to see, getting going with ChassisSim actually isn't all that intimidating. So let's get started. Now, the central tool that you are going to use to help you get up to speed with ChassisSim is the ChassisSim tutorial. Now, when you install ChassisSim, it will install in the ChassisSim Technologies folder, your version number. And if you click under Help, you'll see a folder here called the ChassisSim Tutorial. Now in there, you're gonna have a Word document that outlines everything that you need to do to get rolling. You're going to have a sample car file that's been specifically set up of what car file needs to look like at the end of the process. You're gonna have a setup sheet that will contain a specific setup for what you're going to use. And lastly, what we also give you is a sample monster file so that you've got that to hand. We also give you a data file that you can open up and actually go through and learn how to create a monster file. So let's get going. Now, the ChassisSim tutorial is based around a twin shock formula for eCar. So what we need to do is we go up to the car template menu, which we can access either here, or we can choose model from template. And what we do is that we select the template that's most relevant to our car. Now, the great thing is that we give you quite a few samples to choose from. So you can choose from a V8 supercar. You can choose from an all-wheel drive MY98 Subaru WRX. You've got, if you're running GT3, the LP560 GT3 template is a really good start point. If you are running a moderate downforce open-wheeler slash sports car around about the 500 to 700 kilo mark, and it's a twin spring, the Dallara F3 template is an excellent start point. If you're running any sort of serious high downforce car, whether it be a GP2 car, an LMP2 car, or a P1 car, or even an F1 car, the GP2 2011 template is a very good start point. Now, this is a twin shock formula free car, so I'm going to choose Dallara F3 10, and I'm going to click on OK for that. Now, the next step in this process is we need to do a little bit of housekeeping. Now, the reason we need to do a little bit of housekeeping is so that our directories and files that we're going to generate aren't all over the place. So to that end, what we're going to do is we're going to go back into the ChassisSim Technologies folder. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a folder in there called Models. And because this is a formula free car, I'm going to create a folder in there called Formula Free. And because this is running on the Zandvoort circuit, and for those of you unfamiliar with Zandvoort, that's a circuit in the Netherlands, and literally just down the road from Amsterdam, I'm going to call that Zandvoort. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put all my relevant files in this folder. The reason I'm doing this is that when ChassisSim goes through and you do your bump profiling, you do your tire force modeling, it will save a lot of its folders in the directory the car file is saved. So consequently, what you want to be doing is when you're doing your modeling, you want to keep this all together. Now, to help expedite this process, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to the ChassisSim tutorial. And what I am going to do is I am going to go through, and I'm just going to copy all of this into that particular folder. So I'm going to pop it into my Zandvoort folder and I'm going to paste it in here. So what I'm going to do now is I've selected the appropriate template. What we need to do is we need to save the car file. What the car file is, ladies and gentlemen, is the car file is the ChassisSim equivalent of a Microsoft Word document. What it does is it stores your particular setup, and it stores your particular setup and your vehicle model for that particular instance that you're running with. Also, too, another note on directory conventions. If I was to really drill down on this, I would suggest you would go models, car name, circuit, and then event, whether it was a test, whether it was a race event. So you have all of this. To hand. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to call this Dallara F309 example baseline. I'm going to leave the Dallara F309 example card there just as a reference, because when I go through and create the bump profile, I'm actually going to use that because I've already gone through and set up the model. Now that we've saved that, our next task is to enter the setup. So what we're going to do is the Joker from The Dark Knight, I'm going to show you a little bit of a magic trick here. What I'm going to do here is I am going to just minimize the screen here. And as you can see, I opened up my little Excel document earlier with the setup sheet. I like to have both of these next to each other so I can readily see what's what and what isn't. Now, you'll notice that in this particular setup sheet, I've got a mixture of units here. In particular, I've quoted my springs in pounds force per inch, and I've quoted my bar rates in newtons per millimeter. Okay, how do we get around that? That's real easy. You're going to go to view, select units to use, and in here, you can toggle the units that you need to use. So whether your setup is in imperial units or whether it's in SI units, you can quickly chop and change between the two. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select my units for my springs, pounds force per inch. I'm going to go through and enter in my front and rear spring rates. Now, a thing that we can do here is that we can either use the tree structure, so I'll just click on the front spring, or I can click on the car graphic. Whatever you want to use, it's totally and utterly up to you. So I'm going to enter in my spring rate at 900 pounds force per inch. I'm going to click on OK. I'm going to click on the rear spring, and I'm going to enter that as 700 pounds force per inch, and click on OK. And then what I'll do is, as I go, I am going to use this little disc icon to save my work as I go along. So all you've got to do is go through here, read off all the relevant setup parameters. For example, if I want to change my ride heights, I'm just going to change that to 24. I'm going to click on the rears, change that to change that to 40. And I'll go through and I'll change all these individual elements. So what you're seeing here, ladies and gentlemen, is what you get. And when you're done, you'll have a fully saved car model. Now, what I'll do just to expedite the process, let me just load in the default car file that the ChassisSim tutorial came with, because we're going to need that for when we go through and do our bump profiling. So we've gone through, we've entered our setup. Our next step is to create the circuit model. In particular, what we want to be doing is to create the curvature file, and also we want to create the bump profile. Let's walk you through that. So to do that, we're going to need a monster file. Now, what a monster file is that is your link between your data and ChassisSim. It's an ASCII text tab delimited file that has all the relevant variables that you're going to need, such as RPM, lateral G, longitudinal G, damper, steer, throttle, and speed. Now, I've spoken about the monster file in a number of different tutorials, so I'm not going to go over that just yet. I will refer you to those tutorials. However, what we're going to do is we'll use that supplied monster file to go through our circuit creation process. So we're going to go to circuit, create filter curvature file, and I'm going to click on raw curvature monster file, and I'll click on the monster file here. I'll click here to use a monster file. I'm going to click on moving average filter. If you're just using ChassisSim for the first time, I'd strongly recommend that option. There have been a couple of times where I've explained the differences between that, and that boils down to the quality of your lateral G sensor, but I'm not going to cover that in depth in this tutorial. The other key thing is to make sure you put in the correct frequency of your monster file, which in this case is 50 hertz. I'm simply going to click on output curvature file, and I will call this track Zandvoort F3. Click on open and click on OK. I will now, that will now create my curvature file. And now what I'm going to do is create my bump profile. So I'll go to simulate bump profile modeling. I will click here to add my monster import file. I'm going to click on create bump profile. Now, you'll see here that there are a number of different options that you can, there are a number of different options that you've got to choose from. If you are a newbie, the major thing you're going to play with is maximum bump rate. As a rough rule of thumb, open wheelers slash P2 cars, P1 cars, F1 cars, GP2 cars, you'll leave that at about 0.2. For touring cars, you'll leave at about 0.3. They are some rough rules of thumb to get you going. As you get more experienced, you'll dial that in a little bit more. And in particular, in one of the quick starts, I go into this in further detail. So I would refer you to that. I'm going to click on allow auto bump scaling. I'm going to put max number of bump scale iterations to 3. What this does is it does a number of track replays to determine to determine the level of bumps that you need. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to click here to specify the bump profile location. And I am going to go select choose star.that, and I will call that bump profile Zandvoort F3 and click on OK. And when that's done, I will just click on OK. And what's going to happen now is that we are going to let the ChassisSim bump profiling do its thing. So what it's doing here is it's doing a frequency analysis of the car in heave, pitch, and roll. It's then going to look at the output on input data, look at your actual data, and then go through compare stuff in the frequency domain, and it uses that to go through and reverse engineer what the tracks the bumps on the track are doing. So we're just going to let that run for a moment. Okay, so now it's going through doing the auto bump scaling. And when it's done, that's your bump profile. Now, as a rough rule of thumb, what I will often do is, just as a sanity check to make sure that it hasn't done anything silly, I'll open this up in text in Notepad just to see that the numbers haven't gone stupid. Now, honestly, you don't need to do this. It's just a sanity check I like to do. Another sanity check that I like to do is I will double check what we punched out with the curvature file. So I'll go into Edit Variable Grip Factors. I'll click on Import Curvature File. I'll double click on the curvature file, and lo and behold, we've got something that looks like Zandvoort. Okay, so we've now created our car. So just to summarize where we're at, we've gone through, we've entered our setup, and we've saved the car file. We've created our curvature file. We've created our bump profile. We now are at a point where we can run a simulation. So what we're going to do is I am going to go to circuit data. I'm going to click on my curvature file, and here's my track Zandvoort F3. I am going to click on my bump profile. I'll choose my file filter, star.dat. You'll see I've got two file filters there, star.txt, data file, star.dat. I'll select that, and I will select bump profile Zandvoort F3. Click on open. And I will click on OK. So I've just loaded in my circuit file. Now that we've done that, what we are now going to do is to go through and put this on tape. So what we're going to do is we'll click on one for logging. We're going to log this. We're going to log this to Motec. And what we'll do is we'll call this Solara F309. we're going to go to, we're going to call this Zandvoort. I'm just going to call this initial baseline. I'm going to call this initial baseline. I'm going to click on data file output, double click data, choose the logger of my choice. Click on open, and then I'm good to go. Now, just a couple of tips for those of you who are first getting started. First of all, for those of you who are running Motec, unless you're using Interpreter, which right now I know is a probability of a snowflake surviving in hell, unclick Motec Interpreter format. If you're running Magneto Morelli, you do also have an option of outputting this as an ASCII file. And if you're doing that, you can go through your data browser, click on that, so you've got that to hand. And so we'll click on OK, and we'll go to Start Simulation. Click on Start Simulation, and away we go. So this, ladies and gentlemen, is just how straightforward it is to get going in ChassisSim. And once you've done that, you can open up the logger of your choice and overlay your data and use it like it's actual log data. This is just how straightforward it is to get going with ChassisSim. Now, it's not the complete story. There are a bit of tips and tricks to really refining down what the results are going to look like. However, the key thing though with simulation is to get going. And if you follow this, you work through the ChassisSim tutorial, walk through it a couple of times, and you'll see for yourself just how straightforward ChassisSim is to use. So what we're going to do is we will let the simulation do its thing. And once that is done, you'll come up with your file conversion complete. It'll state what the lap time is. And just to show you what this thing's going to look like, I'll go into my data file. I will go into ChassisSim Technologies, Models, F3, Zandvoort, Data. That's the baseline data. This is what we've just run. And this is what you're looking at. Now, we haven't refined this model at all, but this, ladies and gentlemen, shows you the power that you've got at your fingertips using something like ChassisSim. So, as you can see, to get going with ChassisSim is pretty straightforward, but don't take my word for it. If you're new to ChassisSim and you want to give it a go, sign up for our online simulation. The ChassisSim tutorial and the ChassisSim tutorial is in there. And don't take my word for it. Give it a run and appreciate for yourself what a powerful tool this can be. And we'll catch you in the next ChassisSim video tutorial.